Ladies and gentlemen, the victors of the 74th Hunger Games, Katniss Everdeen and Peter Mullock.
I've always been a big fan of Cannes. I've never been able to come before, but love the movies, the directors that come out of Cannes. And my experience has been rainy, unfortunately, but it's really lovely. Everybody's very nice, and the traffic is pretty intense. Made me feel right at home, like I was back in LA.
She has become a beacon of hope for them. So she has to be eliminated. What do you think?
I agree she should die, but in the right way, at the right time.
It's a little weird because we're not done with the movie, and it feels like I'm on the international tour for, you know, the film, and we're not quite finished with it yet. But sure, it's exciting, and partially because it's my first time here, so it's nice to be here.
Katniss Everdeen is a symbol. We don't have to destroy her, just her image. Show them that she is one of us now. Let them rally behind that. They're gonna hate her so much, they might just kill her for you.
The great thing is it really turns everyone's heads to Cannes for this particular moment. I mean, not only for, you know, this particular movie, but for any movie that's coming here. It's such a big stage.
David, please just help me get through this trip.
This trip doesn't end when you get back home.
So what do we do?
From now on, your job is to be a distraction so people forget what the real problems are.
Chins up, smiles on.
There she is, Katniss Everdeen,
the girl on fire!
This movie is visually kind of huge and stunning, and we dive a little deeper into the Capitol. And, you know, we're back in Katniss's life as she's trying to kind of piece her life back together after the games. And the stakes are a lot higher in this movie.
Go ahead.
Her entire species must be eradicated.
Her species, sir?
The other victors. Because of her, they all pose a threat. Because of her, they all think they're invincible.